Again, a good day for me with the team next to me, which includes Detroit Police Homicide and our commanding lieutenant of the DFAT unit, which is the fugitive apprehension team that is run out of the US Marshals Office but has a bunch of people involved. We got today Derrick Smith, age 42, I believe, who we are convinced is the shooter in the Glastonbury shooting, double homicide, 2.5 weeks ago. In the last 2.5 weeks, these guys, DPD, along with the US Marshals, have worked to execute about, I think they've executed 7 search warrants in this case, trying to gather and glean information to figure out where this gentleman is. He was arrested on the street today in Gardena, California, by the United States Marshals. I think that says a couple things. One is, we said at the time and had some concern when we let the tape out relative to the young girl, that's not something we necessarily wanted to do, but we wanted to get the angst to the community up so that people would in fact call and give information. We've been able to get him today, thank the U.S. Marshals profusely, but the people around me did an awful lot of the legwork that made that happen. He is in custody, and you know, we're just elated with that. And hopefully, the young ladies who were locked in the bathroom, were hid in the bathroom when these shootings went on, at least will be able to start the healing process, knowing that the person we think killed both their mother and at least one of the children's father is in custody. So that's what we've got at this point. He was arrested on the street without a lot of fanfare. The first thing he said was, "Who snitched me out?" I'm sure all of the officers around just smiled and looked at him and said, you know, like we'd tell. But that was a big one. And I'll try to answer some questions in a minute, but we just got another zinger in the last few minutes that also makes me feel very good. You may remember that a couple of days ago there was a guy in circuit court who had been charged with shooting an AK-47 at 2 officers and was on trial and bolted from the court and ran out before the jury could come back and come back with his verdict. I still don't know what the verdict was. His name was Kunta Tolbert. We had been looking for him for a few days. Obviously, a guy that shoots at Detroit police officers with an AK-47 is somebody we'd have a whole lot of interest in. And DFAT caught him hiding in the attic of a house on Larchmont, I believe, in Detroit.
That's correct.
Just a couple of hours ago. So it's been a good day. It's a good day for the work that the police officers have done, but it's also a good day for the collaboration with agencies, which is something he and I try to talk about every time we're out doing something. And again, I think if there's some closure for the family on Glastonbury, at least the beginning of some closure or the opportunity to start some healing, I think that's a good thing too.
Do you know a motive at this time, Chief?
For the Glastonbury. I don't, and I'm not even looking over at homicide because, you know, 2 things are going through my mind. And one of them is never to jeopardize a case. But let me just tell you that he had previous, the deceased and the perp, had previous dealings with each other. They both had previous convictions for assault of crimes and I think some drug things there too. And usually when you see that type of crime, you tend to think that there's some drug involvement.
Extradition.
I don't know whether he's going to fight it, you know, or not, but he's coming back. So it's just, I think it's more just a matter of when than if.
And then who snitched on him?
No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah, right.
but it was
the great citizens of the city of Detroit, hopefully.
So, but there was information here that led you guys to alert authorities in California?
Correct.
Right.
And part of that, you know, anybody who's done search warrants understand when you execute 7 search warrants in 2.5 weeks, that's working. I mean, you know, getting the probable cause for the search warrants, executing the search warrants, tabulating the return on the search warrants, you know, all of those sorts of stuff is real work, because each search warrant requires probable cause again. So I think it just shows you the level of of interest that all of us had in, you know, in homicides generally. But again, you know, you keep playing back over that 6-year-old girl in your mind, and it gives you a little extra energy. And I think everybody had that same energy, and it just turned out very well.
Are these all residences, or are they businesses as well?
Yeah, I don't know. Were they all residences, the search warrants?
Yes.
All were residences.
What's he charged with?
Murder. Let me take a minute and say, you can't go arrest somebody on a murder warrant without the help of the Wayne County prosecutor, and she did a great job on this one too, because we got the warrant quickly. And so, I mean, I talk about the law enforcement people doing, but let's not put the cart before the horse. She was excellent in this case and worked very, very hard with us to help get that murder warrant so that we could grab him.
Two counts of murder, I'm sure, right?
Oh, yes. Thank you, folks. Appreciate it. Thank you, folks.
Happy Friday.
Appreciate it. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.